a lot of people have asked me what my vision for UP is. And I think it's going to evolve over time. I think it's going to be something that's forged with a whole lot of other people. The vision that will eventually come is going to be thoroughly influenced by the vision that Holy Cross has always had for this place. I have a very keen and developed sense that what I'm doing is very much in continuity with what Holy Cross has been doing here for generations. And I feel deeply fortunate to carry that vision forward. I was born in Phoenix, Arizona, and I lived there until I was second grade, and then our family moved to Bakersfield, California. My dad was in graduate studies. My mom was sort of the heart and soul of our family. She was always kind of at the center of everything. I loved being in a family. I had five siblings. My dad always had a pretty high public profile because he was president of a community college, and I thought he taught me a lot about public presence, and he taught me a lot about being a public person. I actually thought about becoming a priest in grade school. That was a passing thought. Started to reconsider it in college. Once I was at the University of Illinois and I saw the outstanding campus ministry operation, that was really instrumental in me thinking about the priesthood as a serious option for the first time. I jokingly say now, I was put in the classroom at a very early age. I was teaching at Notre Dame at age 25, and I just loved it. I really loved it. I could tell I really just drew a lot of energy from being with students. So I went for PhD studies at the Graduate Theological Union at Berkeley. I count it as probably one of the most important periods of my life. I got to the point where I was really immersed in the world of ideas, and I really kind of came alive intellectually there. The character project, I like to tell people, was born out of a conversation that I had with the dean of the business school at Notre Dame at the time, Carolyn Wu. Carolyn and I were in a long conversation about what it would be like to teach a course that engages students in the ethical decisions that they make every day. And I reintroduced it here at UP, and I'm currently team teaching it with others. We spend a lot of time asking some tough questions of students. We ask them to see how they are actually forming their character and how that character influences the way they make decisions. And I think it bears great fruit. I think it's one of the great geniuses of the Congregation of the Holy Cross. We pray with students, we teach students, we live with students, we get to know them well, we counsel them, we preach, we do all of those things. And I just immediately fell in love with that kind of multi-dimensional approach to ministering with students. The living thing is absolutely essential. I've lived in a residence hall for 28 years. There's something irreplaceable about living with them day to day. I wouldn't say it's completely unique, but it's unusual to have somebody in the role of president who has had as much contact and exposure to students as I have. I've said to people, I want to keep teaching as long as I can. I think it gives you a kind of richness and a depth to considering what you're actually doing in terms of running an institution. I'm a big believer that senior leadership ought to be in the classroom. I love the academic excellence. I love the community. The students are just terrific. I love the faculty community and the staff community. I feel like I can be a real spokesperson for the place. When people think about UP, I want them to have front of mind the quality of students that we have here. They are the kinds of people that I think local, regional, national employers are going to be delighted to have in their workforce. And so I've made one of my particular priorities to get lots of people involved in making sure our students find internships and excellent placements after graduation. I go down on that river property and my imagination just goes wild. I think in terms of short term, I think in terms of medium term, and I think in terms of long term, and it's a really bright picture. I love the excitement of the place. I love it's just an unabashedly aspirational place. It's a place that is no accident that this theme for our campaign was rise. You just feel it. You are on the campus and you can feel the place is just aspiring to rise to new heights. He said, "Oh, sir, nice to meet you. Is this your first time at Bandon Dunes?" And I said, "No, I can do you one better. This is my first time golfing." And the look that washed over his face was priceless, because I think he could see that the next 3 days in front of him was going to be pretty much taken up with chasing the golf balls in the bushes. And indeed it was. Sometimes I officiated at their weddings, I baptized their children, and now we've come full circle. I've started to do the weddings of their children. So it's a little humbling. Yeah, well, it was a 340-page dissertation turned into a 180-page book, so there was a lot of fat in it. Don't put that in here.